first team to finish second in the nation. And Jay, you, of course, have been playing Italian ball for the last 2 years. How do you view today's matchup?
Beg your pardon, I didn't hear what you said.
Today's matchup. I'm sorry, the band is a little loud.
Well, I think the key is going to be the inside play. Scott Williams and J.R. Reid have been playing extremely well for North Carolina, as are Ferry and Bricky. But I think when J.R. Reid gets the ball inside, Duke's got to jump down and help on him, because he's only got two assists in the last 2 weeks.
Yeah, and of course, foul trouble, that's going to play a key as well for the big men underneath.
Well, J.R. is just so big. He's like a six-lane highway out there. It's going to be tough for Robert Bricky to get around him, so they're going to have to front him and try to make them lob.
All right, Jay Billis and Phil Ford, they'll be our special guests at halftime on 35 Years of Excellence. We're coming back at half, but right now, we're going to static line.
All right, thank you, Paul. And here we go again. We've got a situation where one team won both games in the regular season, and people are saying how hard it's going to be to win the third one.
That's a very fashionable thing to say, Mike. That's been going on all week because we've had that situation a couple of times. From my standpoint, I think it's a lot of hooey. If I've beaten somebody twice already, I think maybe I'm looking for them for the third time. But most people don't feel that way, and coaches, I think, in particular, started this rumor.
Yeah.
Because a coach is a guy, if he is on a losing streak and he wins the ball game and he's wearing one tie, then he's going to keep wearing that tie. I think one thing that we won't see today, though, on a more serious note, is I don't think we'll see a 17-point game, 15-point game like the last time these two teams played. I think it'll be a very close, intense ball game.
All right, we'll be back with more preceding the ACC championship game between North Carolina and Duke in just one of the keys in this ball game, as it was last night between Duke and North Carolina State, the individual matchups inside.
And I think they're going to be very significant matchups inside. North Carolina, of course, with J.R. Reid and Scott Williams playing very well. Danny Ferry's just done everything for Duke this year. But Robert Bricky and Ala Abdel-Nabi had big games yesterday. They're going to be important.
The Mazda game plan is brought to you by Mazda, and we'll be back with more in just a moment. Orioles at 24-5, the Blue Devils at 23-6 for the ACC championship and a place in history. In the 1950s, Reynolds Coliseum was the mecca of college basketball, and Everett Case was the father of the ACC, cutting down the nets for conference championships in 54, 55, and 56 with players like All-American Ronnie Shavlin. Then Frank McGuire came to North Carolina, and among his legacies, the hiring of Dean Smith and an undefeated national champion led by Lenny Rosenbluth. The ACC championship game had become a major event, but it still paled in comparison with another Everett Case brainchild, the Dixie Classic, the state's Big Four against the best in the country, like Oscar Robertson of Cincinnati. But a Big Four team won it every year with the likes of Billy Packer at Wake Forest and legendary coaches such as Bones McKinney. The 60s brought Vic Bubas to Duke, who dominated the middle of the decade. By then, Dean Smith had North Carolina back on the road to greatness, and 5 years after becoming head coach, won three straight conference championships and made ACC history by reaching the NCAA Final Four all 3 years. Norman Sloan at NC State produced a national championship with the incomparable David Thompson. Lefty Grizzell came to Maryland in 1970 and built a contender with top recruits and a flair for the dramatic. Frank McGuire moved to South Carolina and won the ACC in 71. In 1974, NC State and Maryland played for the ACC title in what many still believe is the best game they ever saw. Then technology changed the face of entertainment. We went from John Wayne to Star Wars, and college basketball became a national craze, and the stars flocked to the ACC like Thurl Bailey at NC State. Len Bias' brief stardom carried Maryland to an ACC title. Michael Jordan produced a national championship for the Tar Heels. Georgia Tech's emergence at ACC title was keyed by Mark Price. Johnny Dawkins, another dominant guard, led Duke to its best season ever. Ralph Sampson was Virginia's greatest recruiting prize, and he was the game's dominant big man of the decade of the 80s. Horace Grant lifted Clemson to the best record in its school history. And Muggsy Bogues of Wake proved that a small star can have a brilliant life. All of that history leads to today's final, with Mike Krzyzewski going after his second ACC title in 8 years with the Blue Devils. One of his stars, Billy King, a player who doesn't even average 5 points a game. He's a brilliant defender. The offense comes from Danny Ferry, who leads the conference in scoring at 19-3. He is the heart of the team. The legend continues for Dean Smith. He's won the ACC tournament a record 9 times. No other active coach has more than 2. To win 10, he'll rely on J.R. Reid, who averages 18 points a game. The other sophomore giant is Scott Williams, more dangerous than his 13-point average. Mike Krzyzewski and Dean Smith bring their teams to Greensboro today for the greatest prize the league has to offer, the ACC championship.
Raycon Sports and Jefferson Pilot Teleproduction proudly present exclusive live coverage of Atlantic Coast Conference basketball, the tournament championship. This game is brought to you by Budweiser, Piedmont Airlines, the Jefferson Pilot Company, First Union, Pepsi, Lowe's, Food Lion, AT&T, Ford, and by Roses.
I think one of the most enjoyable things that we do preparing for games like this, looking through record books and looking at statistics, and we found that North Carolina has only played Duke 3 times for the championship of this tournament. North Carolina has won all 3. You would think, as great as these programs have been over 35 years, they would have played a lot more than 3 times.
A lot more than 3 times in the finals. Of course, yeah, they've played more than that in the tournament. But one of the interesting things about a stat like that, Mike, as Mike Krzyzewski says, that's totally different. It's irrelevant to today's game simply because,
sure,
these are different teams, these are different players, and I think that we're going to just have a very entertaining ball game today.
Let's get the starting lineups for both ball clubs from PA announcer Larry Dunlap.
Greater Greensboro Open Golf Tournament. The starting lineups for the 35th Atlantic Coast Conference Championship between Duke University and the University of North Carolina. First, for the visiting Blue Devils, the forwards, number 21, Robert Bricky. Number 55, Billy King. At center for Duke, number 35, Danny Ferry. The guards, number 14, Quinn Snyder. And 31, Kevin Strickland. Duke's head coach, Mike Krzyzewski. And now for the Tar Heels. At forward, number 34, J.R. Reid. Number 20, Steve Bucknell. The Tar Heels center, number 42, Scott Williams. The guards, number 22, Kevin Madden. And number 14, Jeff Lebo. Head coach of the Tar Heels, Dean Smith. The officials for today's game, Joe Forte, Nick Papero, and Tom Frame.
We are looking forward to an outstanding basketball game between two teams that have combined to win 47 games already this year. And the tension, even though it's not for a bid to the NCAA anymore, the pressure on these two clubs and the respect they have for each other and the intensity with which they play each other should make this just an outstanding day.
It sure should, Mike. The reason you come to play in the ACC is to play in this game.
Yeah.
I honestly believe that. You can play in the ACC or anywhere, and you can make it to the NCAA tournament, but you've got to play in the Atlantic Coast Conference to play in the ACC championship game. And we've been talking for a while now about how this is really the first of all the tournaments. This is, I read someplace where this is the toughest ticket to get ahead of the World Series and,
yep,
ahead of the Super Bowl. So there's a lot of pressure on these teams, and they really are excited to be here. It ought to be a very entertaining basketball game.
Duke won both regular season meetings, and there is the championship meeting history. They have only met 3 times before today, North Carolina winning all 3. But as Dan said, that is history and nothing else. The opening tip controlled by Billy King. He gives it up to Quinn Snyder.
North Carolina going to match up man-to-man.
and JR is on Danny Ferry.
Notice that North Carolina is going to drop way off Billy King when he has the ball out on the perimeter. They're going to try to give some help inside against Fair.
Strickland downtown for three.
Mike Strickland has not had a real good tournament so far. Duke has gotten almost everything inside, and they're awfully tough to beat if Strickland is going to score from outside.
In two games, Danny only had 13 total points. Lebo guarded by King, and that will make it tough on North Carolina's outside game because King is great. That time Lebo got free, though, and you can't let him get free.
King was trying to drop down inside to help out against the big guys, and what Mike Krzyzewski is hoping is that King will be able to do both. He's a great defensive player, but Krzyzewski needs his help down inside as well.
What a start, because Lebo had only had 14 points in two games.
Lebo hasn't really been looking very much for his shot, Mike.
Ferry leans in on JR, got his own rebound. Off of North Carolina, I believe, out to Duke and Div.
Mike, Ferry didn't make those shots, but I think that the way you have to attack North Carolina is to go after those guys inside, and Danny Ferry operates in there very well. Reid and Williams will both have to be careful to avoid foul trouble.
Snyder for three. Another good outside shooter, and he got it.
In the last regular season game, Strickland at 24, Snyder 21.
Williams pump faked on the three-pointer. Here's a tough matchup, Bricky and J.R. Reid. Williams with the follow. Basket won't count, but we have a foul.
And the foul's going to be against Billy King inside. He's playing Jeff Lebo on the perimeter, but he's got to drop down and give help. Bricky matched up against Reid. JR is going to be able to shoot over him all day. I'm sure Duke would like to give some more help. And the foul's on Scott Williams.
Okay.
All right. I thought they called it against Robert Bricky. And then I looked at the replay and I thought maybe it was Ferry, but so I'm wrong. Third time's a charm. It's on Scott Williams.
We'll get it right eventually. It's 6-3 Duke. Ferry for three more. King trying to keep it alive. Good job by Bucknell.
Madden trying to block out Billy King was overmatched in there. Bucknell really bailed him out. Duke in the man-to-man. And the big guys inside will switch a lot, so you won't see Bricky matched up constantly against Reid.
Ferry's on him right now.
Danny Ferry is a person who should be attacked inside as well, so I'm sure you'll see North Carolina put the ball in JR's hands and in Scott Williams' hands.
When Snyder bounced it off Bucknell's knee, and it's Duke's basketball.
I think one thing that we ought to see today, Mike, on both sides is great defense. Duke, of course, has had the reputation the last few years as just an intense defensive team. North Carolina has that history as well, and Carolina's played outstanding defense in this tournament.
Strickland needs some help, gets it from King. Foul away from the ball. It's going to be on Danny Ferry, bumping in with Reid.
If you're going to get position inside against J.R. Reid, you're really going to have to work very hard. Reid bigger than Ferry physically. Danny's going to try to get inside. We don't see the foul right there, but Ferry trying to get position.
Lebo has the thumb up, calling the play for his teammates. Nice fake, and then Lebo leaned into Billy King, and pretty lucky that he got the foul call on King.
That lean-in is a good point, Mike. Jeff Lebo is going to pump fake. King is going to leave his feet. Now, King did go into him. King's the guy that broke the plane, but Lebo, he lowered his shoulder and made sure that it wasn't going to be incidental contact.
Second team foul against Duke. First on Billy King. Bucknell kicks it back to Madden. Good outside shooter. That's for three.
Mike, I really believe that the team that wins this game is going to get the best inside-outside combination going. When we talk about inside-outside, that's exactly what we mean. Penetrate inside, draw the defense, and then hit it from three-point range.
But what's amazing with all the great big players on the court, we've had 4 3-point shots so far. Snyder missed the first two, and Ferry tips it in.
And there's your first scoring inside by a big guy. And one of the reasons for that is the teams are very conscious of the inside game. So those fellas from three-point range are going to have some shots. They're going to have to get them to go down.
Game is already being played with great intensity.
Williams did a nice job to handle that ball. It's always tough to pick up that bounce pass at your toes.
Look how far Reid had to come out to get it, and Ricky's right with him.
That's a great defense.
It's usually what North Carolina specializes in, making you start your offense 30 feet away.
Look at Reid has the ball dead in the corner. He's just not going to be effective from there.
Shot clock is down to 8. JR missed the runner. Got a foul inside. It will go against the Blue Devils. And it's Bricky.
That foul is against Robert Bricky. Bricky does a nice job moving his feet. JR penetrates into the lane. Don't see JR Reid drive much from the corner all the way in. Bricky over the back of Kevin Madden. Bricky jumps very well, but he's only 6'5", and as a result, trying to play against bigger people inside, he is susceptible to foul trouble.
That is the third team foul against Duke. Bricky in the first two games, 22 points and 19 rebounds, many of them offensive. Madden. Ferry with a rebound. Bodies fly again. And another foul against Bricky.
It's very, very difficult, and I know this from personal experience, to try to match up with bigger guys inside, particularly on the boards. Bricky just shoved him out of the way.
Two fouls on Robert Bricky, four on Duke in 4 minutes. It's Duke by two. We'll be back after this from Budweiser. The Duke Blue Devils went on to finish second in the NCAA after beating Wake Forest, Virginia, and Georgia Tech in a memorable final, 68-67, here in Greensboro. In fact, they have not lost a game on this floor since the finals of the 1984 tournament when they lost to Maryland. They have won 12 of their last 13 here in Greensboro. And in 1982, North Carolina last won its tournament championship and went on to win the NCAAs.
John Smith in the ball game now for Robert Bricky.
5 second call against North Carolina. They didn't get the ball inbound.
Mike, it used to be the conventional wisdom in basketball said never play man-to-man on the underneath out-of-bounds play. Everybody, and a lot of teams around the country zone that. But Duke playing very tough man-to-man denied it and got the 5 second call. And Strickland doesn't have time to tie his shoe. He's got to be careful.
Strickland goes baseline, got cut off.
And his shoelace is flapping in the breeze.
Snyder being taken by Lebo. Ferry over JR. Got it.
Boy, he's a player. He is just a player.
Danny Ferry with 4. He may be in contention for the tournament MVP coming into the game already. 35 points in the first two. Williams, who developed that outside shot, missed this one. Loose ball. Madden. JR caused that.
JR isn't going to get credit for an offensive rebound, but a man that big who can make a play that delicate, and that is jump up over somebody's back, knock the ball out of his hand without touching it.
Great catch by John Smith, but he missed the shot. Snyder's pass a little strong, and Smith did an excellent job just to bring it down. Lebo, excellent pass to Williams, but stripped and taken away by the Blue Devils.
Quinn Snyder really saved Danny Ferry that time. Ferry slipping up the court.
Another great pass. Ferry hit John Smith. He missed the shot, but he's fouled. And that one will be on JR.
We saw two sequences where both teams a little slow getting down the court defensively. John Smith ran very well, got himself in position. He draws the foul, doesn't make the shot, but a nice job by John Smith to run the floor.
One on JR, only the second team foul against North Carolina. The other was on Williams. And Smith, who is now coming off the bench instead of being used as a starter, goes to the line, 73% shooter. Has the first, and the lead goes to 3. And I think we both agree that one of the keys in this game may be Abdel Nabi off the Duke bench.
Abdel Nabi had 12 points yesterday to go along with Bricky 16 and John Smith 6. That's an awful lot of points in the post position for Duke. And Bricky is out of the game now with 2 personal fouls. We may not see him again this half.
Ranzino Smith into the North Carolina lineup for the first time. Snyder reached around, hit the ball again. This one's knocked out of bounds, out to Carolina. Snyder, or out to Duke. Snyder very, very active on defense.
One of the things about each of these teams, Mike, that you're not going to have very many uncontested drives or uncontested passes or uncontested shots.
Snyder left Ranzino standing flat-footed and blew down the lane, got some defensive help.
Nothing's going to be easy offensively.
North Carolina with four turnovers early. Billy King with a rare drive. King and Lebo on the floor. Jump ball situation, possession arrow to North Carolina.
You can see the difference in philosophy there, Mike, where Mike Krzyzewski did not elect to have his players play zone on the out-of-bounds play. Dean Smith's North Carolina Tar Heels did play zone. Billy King recognized, split the zone very easily, but couldn't make the layup.
There's the turnover story through the first 6 minutes of the ballgame. 4-point lead for Duke, and the Blue Devils have taken advantage of this turnover. Ranzino lost it on the way, but he is fouled by Phil Henderson, who's into the ballgame and reached in on him.
Ranzino Smith has really provided some offensive spark off the bench for North Carolina in this tournament. That's a clear foul on Henderson. That's a difficult temptation to resist if you're a defensive player, to reach in when the ball's right there, but you have to resist it.
Abdel Nabi checks in for the first time, and Billy King will sit down, and I think you're going to look at the best free throw shooter in the country right now. He's at 44-46, and they don't even touch the rim. Whoops.
There's nobody better than you at that.
No. I hate getting credit. And that's the first one, the two he missed, I did not see this year. Rick Fox is into the game for the first time.
One thing with a guy like that, he makes a very high percentage, but he shoots very few, so you have to avoid fouling him.
That looks more like it for Ranzino. It's 12-9, Duke. Lebo stepping up the pressure a little bit. Henderson working it up. Nice backdoor to Snyder to get free, and Snyder guns one when nobody was looking.
He had an open shot, Mike, that he passed up.
Lebo for three over Reid screen, got it. 2-for-2 from downtown for Lebo.
Jeff Lebo in this tournament has not really seemed to look for his shot, but he's certainly looking for it today.
Ferry with Reid 25 feet away from the bucket right in his face.
It's good to apply pressure against Ferry out there, but JR certainly doesn't want to foul.
Abdel Nabi on the way up, stripped by Fox. Lebo's looking for the shot again. To Chilcutt, to Ranzino for three. Oh, man. Carolina takes the lead by three.
Strap yourself in here, buddy, I think.
Yeah. Better get a face mask and a big helmet. Blocking foul this time as Ferry got to the baseline, was cut off by Fox.
The teams are helping one another inside very, very well. But I think if the three-point shooting continues, the defense just by nature has to stretch. And then I think we're going to get a very open, flowing, up and down kind of game.
King and Bricky are back in the Duke lineup. And Strickland also checks back in. So now the only change from the starters has Henderson out there.
North Carolina scoring the last 7 points of the basketball game. And if Duke has a weakness, it is that every once in a while, Duke goes into a stretch where they're not able to put the ball in the basket. They'd certainly like to avoid that today. They've gone 2 minutes without scoring, and they'd like to end that drought right here.
And here's Chilcutt anticipating the pass, reaching over Bricky, picking up the personal. It's number one on Chilcutt.
North Carolina, again, zoning the out-of-bounds play, and Chilcutt is about 6'9". If Bricky's going to catch the ball down there, he's got to make sure that he's behind Bricky when he catches the ball and force Bricky to shoot over the taller person. That's not a very good play by Chilcutt to foul Bricky right there.
Scott Williams comes into the ballgame, and Reid will get his first rest.
North Carolina now the 1-3-1 zone on the out-of-bounds play.
Three-pointer by Strickland, short, goes after the rebound, really physical. Lebo wraps it up like a football fullback. Chilcutt. Nice rebound to Bricky.
You can see how high he can get off the ground.
Oh, man. Ferry, great catch to save it. Nice pass to Bricky. Chilcutt with a block, but the foul. Two quick ones on nice. The freshman from Utah, Alabama.
This is a great pass by Ferry. Now, you can't let Bricky catch the ball there because he's going to go up and try to dunk it. You've got to stay between Bricky and the basket. Chilcutt did not do it, and he drew the foul.
Fifth team foul on North Carolina. Duke also has five. And Chilcutt, after those quick two, will sit down. And Madden comes back in the ballgame. So Mike, now they've got a three-guard offense.
We may not have blazing speed and quickness out here on the court, but we don't have any plotters out here either. These people run up and down the court very, very well.
Bricky was so impressive yesterday, hits the first free throw.
And Bricky operates very well inside. The only person on Duke's team who shot more free throws than Bricky this year is Danny Fair.
Mm-hmm. There were his numbers against North Carolina State. Missed the second free throw, however. Carolina by two and possession of the ball. Ranzino had a three. Threw it inside. King. And Ranzino just reached out and pushed him.
A lot of people have wanted to do that to Billy King during his career. Ranzino with the pump fake starts to penetrate. Nice job by Henderson. You see King just drops down and takes it. Ranzino just pushes him away. Understand his feelings.
And then smile when they called the foul. It's a two-point game. Back in a moment. So far, North Carolina shooting 50%. Duke slightly under that mark. But what brings the field goal shooting percentages up, the three-point field goals, especially for Carolina. You take 50% shooting on three-point field goals, it's equivalent to 75% shooting on the two-point.
And North Carolina, who has been almost totally inside-oriented in this tournament, J.R. Reid hasn't scored a point yet. Scott Williams hasn't scored a point yet. They're doing most of it from the perimeter. And as they continue to hit from the perimeter, that's going to open things up inside.
We talked all morning about what a powerful inside game it would be. We're off again. Bricky drives the baseline, and we've got a blocking foul down there.
Robert Bricky has real good quickness. Just beats Kevin Madden to the baseline. You can see him slide that knee in there. And that's one of the reasons why Bricky's so tough. Now, Kevin Madden is listed as a guard for North Carolina, and if he has a hard time staying with Bricky, imagine how the bigger guys inside who have to guard Bricky, what a tough time they would have.
And they're both 6'5", but Bricky can really sky. Goes to the free throw line, trying to cut into the lead, and does. Down to one, has a chance to tie it right now.
Mike Krzyzewski's got to be concerned about the fact that his team having a difficult time scoring from the field over the last couple matches.
We're tied at 15 with 11:42 to go first half. King Rice, number 21, into the game for the first time. He will run the Tar Heel offense.
And you notice Billy King matched up against King Rice. Mike Krzyzewski likes King to play the point of attack.
Madden getting more offensive-minded as the season wears along and scores.
Nice movement by North Carolina.
Henderson guarded by Fox. There are some strange matchups out there. Bricky, the perimeter shot. Got his own rebound. Saved it, but stepped on the end line.
Bricky is not a perimeter shooter, at least not during this stage of his career. So you'll see Madden or whoever's guarding Bricky play off of him on that play.
Abdel Nabi is back in. Bricky will get a breather.
And it's possible that Mike Krzyzewski is going to tell Bricky that he's not a perimeter player at this stage of his career. Of course, I guess now he's really on the perimeter.
Yes. Bucknell into Fox. What a shot by Fox. And Ferry, I think, really concerned about getting into foul trouble, not being terribly aggressive on defense.
Duke is trying to switch when North Carolina's big guys cross inside, and that was the second time in this game that nobody saw the inside player.
Unbelievable pass by Ferry to Strickland. I don't know how anything as big as a basketball got through there.
That's right, all those hands and everything that were there.
For the second year in a row, Ferry with more than 100 assists. Bucknell, not known for his perimeter shot either.
He had his career high the last time these two teams played, though, and many of them were from the perimeter.
Ferry to Abdel Nabi. Somehow he got it, and Fox with a great block.
Once again, Ferry makes a good pass, but Abdelnaby couldn't handle it. And sometimes you throw a pass and it's just impossible to handle, but this one should have been caught. Abdelnaby misses it the first time. Now watch Fox. He comes over, just plants his hand solidly on the ball. Kevin Madden does a nice job getting in there to bother Abdelnaby, but you can see Fox, that's clearly, he's got his hand right on the ball.
Superb play. Carolina by two, Duke's ball.
You got to be careful holding the ball down there against North Carolina.
John Smith trapped, gets it back to Snyder. Smith again in the middle of a double team.
Very small lineup in the ball game now for North Carolina.
Henderson on the way up is fouled.
Not a good foul by Ranzino Smith. I was wondering what Henderson was going to do here if he got his feet off the floor. Going to attempt a very difficult shot. Ranzino Smith sneaking in from behind. And usually if you're a guard and you're going to sneak up on somebody, you've got a better chance getting the ball on the dribble. Once the guy gets it in his hand, you're going to get a foul.
Ranzino picks up his second personal. Henderson will shoot one and one. Since he has come to Duke, I have always been struck turning around, seeing him in that dark blue uniform, and he looks so much like Johnny Dawkins facially.
This play has really improved recently as well, Mike. He hit a big, big three-point basket in that semifinal victory.
Nice touch on the second free throw. We're tied again at 19 and under 10 minutes to go in the first half.
Now, North Carolina really should work hard to get the ball inside. They're massive in terms of the advantage in there.
We have gone, Ranzino puts it up, we have gone more than 10 minutes. Reid and Williams have yet to score. Snyder had it blocked by Williams. Reid got it back, but Reid's fouled by John Smith. I wonder when the last time you had to get down to 9.5 minutes before Reid and Williams scored in the ballgame.
That's an amazing stat. Scott Williams has become an excellent shot blocker for the North Carolina Tar Heels. Got that one there. And Duke, if you look out on the court and you see Scott Williams and J.R. Reid in the ball game at the same time, Williams about 6'11", Reid about 6'10". The tallest guy out on the court for Duke is John Smith, and he's about 6'7". So North Carolina really should take some time and get the ball inside.
Lebo and Henderson really working on each other, and Henderson is called for the foul.
Henderson trying to battle through J.R. Reid. Now, you can't push J.R. that easily, but again,
that was a great act by Lebo, too. Because Lebo was not, he was reaching out to hold Henderson and then pushing on J.R. Reid, and it looked like Henderson was doing the holding.
Lebo does so many little things and does them so effectively.
I think he understood the game of basketball by the time he was 8.
Another thing about Lebo, he always has that hurt expression on his face. So you just feel sorry for him. He looks like he's in pain most of the time.
He's a terrific player. And he's looked for a shot today. And when he does, boy, is he dangerous. North Carolina's lead back to 2. Snyder back in the game to handle the pressure of King Rice. And whips that one out of bounds.
Bucknall denying the pass, and it looked to Quinn Snyder that if Henderson would go to the corner, then he'd be open, and that's so, but the same thought did not occur to Phil Henderson.
Duke puts Billy King back out on the court. Here's the turnover situation, even early. Lebo walked.
And that's what Billy King is in there to do, to run at Jeff Lebo to force him to pass up that three-pointer. You don't see Lebo often walk off that pump fake, but he did that time.
Snyder again against King Rice, and now Ferry will help bring it up.
And with J.R. Reid matched up against Danny Ferry, that really negates any full-court pressure that North Carolina can apply, because Ferry can bring it up easily against J.R.
Smith tried to get it to Strickland, Lebo, in the, or to Smith. And Jeff Lebo stepped in. A lot of jump ball situations already, and the possession arrow will give it to North Carolina.
Teams are really battling, Mike, and I think that's why you have a lot of jump ball situations.
Ooh. Yes, ooh. tip by Williams almost went Ferry with a rebound.
And Quinn
there are
Snyder's
some vicious screens.
Quinn Snyder's got to shake himself, make sure everything still works.
Strickland, a runner. Pretty shot, tied at 21 again.
Strickland is looking for his shot too, Mike, and he's making it today.
He has 7 points. Duke's leading scorer, J.R., tries to go baseline, and the foul is on J.R.
J.R. Reid does not like that call. But John Smith, hurrying to follow J.R. through, gets there. It did not look like he had his position established from that slow motion replay. It looked like he bounced JR out of bounds. But that's the hardest call in basketball to make. The officials don't have the advantage of the slow motion.
Ferry with King Rice on it, gets it to Smith. What a shot. Oh, man. Duke is up by two. What a great first half this has been. Williams for three.
That's the first three-point attempt he's missed in this tournament. And you say, well, how many has he taken? Well, he was 3 of 3.
Billy King. Strickland for three. Ferry tried to keep it alive. Bodies going everywhere. And John Smith called for pushing off underneath as Scott Williams went flying.
Duke is a very physical basketball team, and when you're playing guys much bigger than you are, you've got to be physical with them. You can see Scott Williams doing a great job blocking out. That's what creates this play. Watch Williams turn, get his body into him, and you can see Smith just clearly wraps those arms around him and throws him down.
Smith got the takedown and the foul.
Now, sometimes you won't get that foul if you're somebody like Scott Williams. Well, no, you always get it if you're Scott Williams. If you're some big clumsy guy, the official might look at that and think you're supposed to fall down. But Williams, what a super job to block out John Smith.
You sound like you were speaking from experience.
Well, you didn't have to say that, Mike.
Williams at the line. He seems to have gotten stronger as the season has gone on. I know they were concerned about his conditioning earlier in his career, but he just seems like he's really grown into that big body.
He really has, and he just, the improvement, you know, J.R. Reed's a great player, but in terms of his physical skills, I don't see that much improvement in J.R. from this year to last year. It's mainly mental with J.R., but with Scott Williams, there's a lot of physical improvement as well.
I agree. Game tied for the seventh time. We're knotted at 23. 7:43 to go in the first half of the ACC Championship. We'll be back after this message from Budweiser. Part of our 35 years of excellence, Paul Cameron will be talking with Jay Billison, Phil Ford. More information on the book and tape available at 1-800-531-5314. We're tied with 7:43 to go. First half of play from Greensboro in the ACC Championship. And this is hard to believe. Points from the paint for these two clubs, 6 combined points in 12 and a half minutes of the tournament championship.
J.R. Reid hasn't scored. Scott Williams has only 2. And if you're Duke, that's got to be frightening because the score's tied. But by the same token, Duke hasn't scored inside very well either.
Sometimes I get the feeling the more games you see, the less you understand. Ferry with a runner.
Well, that's certainly true in my case, Mike.
No, I wasn't referring to you. That was the group you understand. Duke by a bear. Sagging in on Williams. Fox got caught up in the air but found Williams. Big drive there. Shot won't go. Reid with a long rebound.
That was pretty good defense by Danny Ferry. He made the contact just enough to throw the shot off, but it wasn't enough to get a foul.
Fox, offensive foul, Rick Fox.
Dean Smith does not like the call. Rick Fox trying to penetrate. You notice Lebo steps in. Now look at Billy King. He stops Lebo, then steps back to Fox, moves the feet as Fox lowers that shoulder just a little bit. King goes down.
Didn't look like a whole lot of contact on the floor.
Well, I think Dean Smith would agree with you about that particular issue.
Duke by 2. Smith, nice job to save the ball. Strickland, big drive and got the roll.
And Fox tried to force him to the baseline, so Strickland went there, but the help didn't come as they thought it would. And now Billy King is going to get a foul trying to reach over the back of Kevin Madden.
Saw the pass coming and went for the steal, commits his second personal. Madden's or Bucknall's back in the game.
Madden's another one of those guys that runs the court pretty well, gets good position, steps to the basketball, so Billy King fouls him. Now, by March, Mike, I don't really think anybody's really a freshman anymore. Mm-hmm. But Madden, while, of course, he's not actually a freshman, but he sat out all last year, so I think that he has come on very, very well for North Carolina. Talk about players who've shown some improvement. He has.
Sure has.
But it's like starting all over for him again after sitting out last year.
He and Lebo are leading North Carolina right now with 8 points apiece. Strickland is Duke's leading scorer. He has 9. Henderson will come back in the ballgame, and Billy King with those two personals will come out. 6:33 to go, first half. J.R. Reid had 40 points in the first two games of the ACC tournament. He has not scored in this game. He has rarely touched the ball.
Duke has done a nice job keeping the ball away from him, but I think North Carolina has to work harder to get the ball to a guy like that.
Reid, good hustle, knocked it away from Ferry, and both teams going in a very physical man-to-man. I mean, they're coming after each other. Snyder for three. Ferry, offensive rebound. Reid with a big rejection. The kick it back out to Strickland. Ferry, his outside shooting has fallen off, but not that time.
Looks like he got pushed a little bit by Lebo, who pushed him at the hip when he shot the ball. Very nice job by Ferry.
Lebo with a runner really forced it up. Strickland saves it in the corner. In this game, 4 points is a big lead, and here's Ferry with a three-pointer. And here comes Lebo back the other way. Lebo and Smith from behind with a brilliant defensive play. Lebo never saw him.
Lebo saw him at the last minute, and how Lebo got rid of that ball without having it blocked or without a violation is amazing.
JR still scoreless. Lebo with a follow. What a terrific play.
Talk about role reversal. JR Reid shoots the perimeter jumper. Jeff Lebo with the follow shot inside. And we're going to look at Lebo. We're going to say, well, he's got 10 points, so that's the perimeter game. But that's Lebo in the colored area of the lane. That's not JR's shot. I think that's a little frustration, him shooting that ball. But look at Lebo battling in there. Gets the ball. Looks like Shackelford in there.
That's right.
Shot with his back to the basket.
No, he did that with his right hand. What a game this has been, and we've got 5:13 to go in the first half. Duke 29, Carolina 27. This is why people go crazy in the ACC tournament. Strickland outside to Henderson for three. Bill Henderson with 5 points, and Duke with a 5-point lead. That's their biggest. King Rice is in there. This is Bucknall to the baseline. And a foul against Carolina underneath, going after the rebound.
That's a tough shot by Bucknall, Mike. And it, North Carolina is simply not being very patient on offense. They make one pass, then a dribble. Watch Bricky there, headlock on J.R. Reid. Then he gives that up, and he goes down and gives good help there. But that's simply not very good patience by North Carolina. The Tar Heels are always most effective in their passing game offense when they pass the ball 3 or 4 times, move the defense around, and create some openings inside, and they haven't been doing that.
And when they did that against Georgia Tech, they played, I thought, their best game of the year. They had a brilliant passing game. Strickland at the line, 1-1. One of the better shooters around, 80%.
When you're talking about passing the ball and moving, Mike, Duke is trying to switch on the inside. And I really think you can create some mismatches inside if you let J.R. Reid and Scott Williams interchange and move around a few times before you shoot the basketball.
Strickland into double figures. Hits another one, and the Blue Devils now on top by 7. They're building on that biggest margin. JR has Bricky on him again. And JR loose that time, but he walked.
Pretty good defensive help by the Duke Blue Devils that time. But there, Mike, you saw a perfect illustration of what we are talking about. They move the ball from side to side a couple of times. J.R. Reid gets to go through the lane, through all that congestion and those screens, and suddenly he's wide open inside.
North Carolina turned it over 9 times each in the first 2 games. They've already had 9 turnovers against Duke, and we have 4:20 to go first half. Ferry with a jump hook. What a pretty shot.
Duke is starting to be very effective offensively. They're beginning to get the ball inside.
36-27 Blue Devils. King Rice with the drive. Lebo for 3. Really got the shot today. Lebo with 13.
And that is a big, big basket. Duke would look like they were ready to run away with the game.
Strickland. Sort of short arm, but Ferry got wrapped up inside. The foul is on Lebo. Hey, 2 players, 1 each had an arm, and they were saying make a wish because Ferry wasn't going anywhere.
World Wrestling Federation would be very pleased with this. Look at JR and Ferry. They're locked up. Lebo karate chops Ferry on the back of the neck. Strickland with the jump shot. As we mentioned, he's been very aggressive, but look at that battling inside.
That's unbelievable.
And everybody on the North Carolina bench is livid about that call.
It's been that kind of game. They're trying to work the officials. Every time they run by the bench, they let them have it.
And it's amazing how many officials, how many referees we have in the stand. You know, as a
16,000.
Right, everybody's making the traveling sign or calling for a foul or a technical or something. It's very entertaining, particularly the fans behind the benches. They're the ones who really get into it, I think, in terms of officiating a little more than anybody else.
37-30, Ferry in and out on that one. Bricky had a shot at the offensive rebound, couldn't hold it.
That's just quickness. He just beat Scott Williams to the spot. Bob Stack right there watching the ball game.
We have a timeout in Greensboro. 3:43 to go first half. Duke 37, North Carolina 30. Back in a moment. Championship game, we'll be choosing a player from each team as the Holly Farms player of the game. We've already had some tremendous performances. 3:43 to go first half. Duke 37-30 over North Carolina. Outside of guards, North Carolina has 4 points. 4. The guards have done the rest. Fox on a drive, fouled by Snyder. That'll be 1 on the junior out of Mercer Island, Washington.
I think Mike Krzyzewski is up asking Quinn Snyder why he would foul King Rice on this particular play. King Rice, not really a person with a jump shot, but he gave a pump fake. Snyder went for the pump fake, and Rice drove by.
Only a 42% shooter from the floor. He's an excellent free throw shooter, but the wisdom seems to be that you back off of Rice and make him shoot the ball.
Well, you certainly don't want a fellow like that on the free throw
no.
line.
You joined us late. J.R. Reid has not scored in the ball game. Williams has only 2 points. And the people that you normally look to, who average together 31 points a game, have 2 so far. It's really hard to understand so far.
North Carolina now playing zone defense. They've played very little.
Snyder for 3. Lebo with a loose ball.
Good
5-point game now.
Good lockout by Bucknall.
Rice, the alley-oop was short. Good defense by Bricky. Got a hand on it. 4-on-2, Ferry.
He walked. And the person that caused that walk was Jeff Lebo. Lebo forced Snyder to give up the ball and then drifted over to Danny Ferry. And Ferry, trying to avoid the charge, sort of shuffled his feet while he was getting in position for the shot.
Under 3 minutes to go first half. And there is what the backcourts have done today.
And you can see that Duke has much better balance between the backcourt and the front court than North Carolina.
Rice can't handle it. Here comes Henderson. 2-on-2. Henderson will go in against Rice. Some contact, no whistle.
Good defense by King Rice.
Lebo pulls up for another 3-pointer. This one won't go.
Again, Mike, North Carolina not exercising, much patience on the offensive end of the floor.
And that's not like North Carolina. And it's out of bounds out to North Carolina. Danny Ferry grabs his hand.
Well, that's what everybody from North Carolina is yelling about, that Madden threw it off Danny Ferry's hand. They're really upset over there.
Right in front of their bench. They didn't like the call at all.
Let's see if we can pick up. You see Ferry sort of pushes off Scott Williams there. And he, gee.
I think he missed him. Ferry grabbed his hand before on the reach in.
But it looked to me like the ball went in the direction of Ferry and then flew in the other direction. And I don't see how the ball can go that way unless it hit Ferry right in the arm.
You could be right. Snyder is back in the ballgame. Bricky will come out. We're down to 2:04 to go. And it's Duke's basketball for the 5-point lead. King Rice pass was telegraphed. Here's Ranzino. Missed the layup. Fox. Great job by the trailer.
Nice job by Rick Fox to get down and tip that ball in. Pretty good defense on both ends of the court. Rice with the steal, and then Quinn Snyder forced Smith to miss that layup.
Seen some tremendous defense in the first 20 minutes of basketball. King is low. Tries to roll to the basket, fouled by Madden.
Foul's going to be called against Scott Williams. Billy King penetrating to the basket on the dribble. North Carolina giving good help. And that's probably not a bad foul. We were talking about people who you'd rather have shoot the ball than go to the free throw line. Well, Billy King's one of those guys who you'd probably rather have go to the free throw line than to shoot the shot inside.
Chilcutt is back in the game. And that was called on Williams, his second. King has had his problems as a free throw shooter. A little strong on that, and he kicks out on it. North Carolina down by three. They've come back from that 9-point deficit. And they've done it without inside scoring. And right now, Williams and Reid are not even in there.
This is not a very strong offensive lineup for North Carolina.
Rice to Chilcutt, Ranzino for three. Got that touch. We're tied again at 37. That's a big run by Carolina.
It sure is, Mike. And again, the Duke Blue Devils sometimes struggle on offense because they have a tough time shooting the ball.
Dick Paparo comes over to say something to Mike Krzyzewski.
I don't think he was asking him where he's going to go eat after the game.
Don't think so. He certainly wasn't out of the box. I don't know what he may have heard something. But Dick's got better ears than I do because he's 45 feet across the court from Krzyzewski.
Well, you got earphones on too, though.
This is true. Henderson throws it away. And North Carolina is putting the pressure on right now.
Duke has not scored a field goal, as you saw on your screen, in over 3 minutes in this basketball game. And you have said it a couple of times, Mike, that's a very fine defensive effort by both squads. And North Carolina's defense has gotten them back in the ball game. That and their three-point shooting.
Chilcutt. Ranzino tries a runner this time. Fox offensive rebound knocked away by King and stolen by Henderson.
What a great play by Henderson to reach up from underneath. Now, if you slap down at that ball, you get a foul. But if you reach up from underneath, you have a better chance of stealing it, and that's what Henderson did.
Duke wants to hold the ball for the last shot. Snyder almost walked. Strickland. Offensive foul on Strickland.
One fine defensive play after another. Snyder doing a nice job holding that pivot foot. Strickland trying to jump around Rick Fox, but was not able to do it without making some contact. Fox had his position established.
So now North Carolina will try to hold for the last shot. King Rice has played a lot in this first half.
I thought he had a real good semifinal game, and he's picked up where he left off.
He'll pull up for his own jumper, which you really don't expect from him, with the miss. And there's the buzzer. What an intense first half of basketball as North Carolina and Duke go after the ACC championship. Boy, everything we could ask for.
I think intensity is the word that best describes the first half, Mike. Good defensive play on both sides. Startlingly, at least to me, is that J.R. Reid has not scored in the first half. Scott Williams only has 2 points. So two guys who we thought would be the key to the game for North Carolina have only scored 2 points between them, but Lebo and Smith and Madden have really done a job.
We're at halftime at the ACC Championship game. Scoring factors for the Championship game. Scoring factors for the Blue Devils. For North Carolina, it has been all guards led by Lebo, who has done a great job outside. 13 points, Madden with 9, Smith off the bench with 7, and you don't see the name of J.R. Reid or Bucknall, two of the starters up front. They have not scored in the first half.
Mike, and you talk about the job that Jeff Lebo has done in the first half. Not only is he leading North Carolina in scoring, but he's also the leading rebounder at halftime for North Carolina. He's got 5, J.R. Reid has 4.
One of the officials working today's game, Tom Frame, is working the last game of his illustrious career. Tom has decided that he is going to hang it up and enjoy his life. And we wish Tom Frame all the best. He is a class official, one of the best this conference has ever had.
And he's also a real class person.
Yes,
Mike.
He is.
One of the real nice fellas associated with this league. And as you say, we just wish him all the best.
And he promised he'd come back and visit.
He probably won tickets.
Points from inside. Duke with 10, North Carolina with only 6.
And it's surprising for Duke, too, because they're more of an inside team than a perimeter team. So both teams doing a great job defending inside.
20 minutes of action still to come. The ACC championship on the line.
Now, Duke finished the first half with a tough stretch in terms of scoring. They were outscored 10-1.
King to Ferry. Jump hook over J.R. in and out. Williams with a rebound.
And that wasn't an open shot. J.R. Reid got there and was in good position and forced Ferry to shoot that little hook instead of a jumper.
Let's see if they try to push it inside first time down. They do, and Williams fouled on the way up by Snyder. And Snyder just decided there was no way he was going to get the layup.
Those of us sitting here watching, Mike, are aware that the ball's not going inside very much. And you can see from the replay that there's nobody around Scott Williams. And you know that the North Carolina coaching staff went in. If we noticed it, certainly Dean Smith, who's won so many basketball games, it wasn't a mystery to him. That what he did is he diagrammed something up and said, look, we're going to get the ball inside.
Williams will go to the free throw line. Scott with 2 points in the ball game, both coming on free throws in the first half.
Tom Frame doing a little housekeeping. There's a lot of television equipment, lights and such,
cables.
And so Tom is just making sure that they're stowed properly underneath the table.
Don't grab a hot one, Tom. It's your last game. Williams will go to the free throw line. It's North Carolina by 1.
And I really think it's important, Mike, that Duke score. Obviously, they're not going to win the game with 37 points when they were tied at halftime, but they're really in a long drought here, covering the end of the first half and now the start of the second.
J.R. with a nice steal. He'll handle it himself on the break to Bucknall. Back to J.R. Fouled by Billy King.
That says something about the strength of J.R. Reid. It was a 2-on-4 situation. Reid, very nice. That's, you know, very delicate, again, play. It's so wonderful for North Carolina that he can make a play that smoothly. But there he steps right into three guys, puts some pressure on the defense, draws Billy King's third foul.
Carolina by 2 with the ball. Quinn Snyder and Lebo going after each other. Backdoor cut by Madden. Missed the shot. Ferry with a long rebound.
Good defense by Ferry coming to help out against Madden. Looked like he had an open shot, but Ferry cut it off.
Ferry is so smooth. Drives the baseline on J.R. That was blocked by Williams, who came over to help. 2-on-4 break. Bucknall to Lebo. Into Reid. Snyder knocked it away. Foul on Quinn Snyder.
And each time, the last two times down the court, North Carolina has been able to recognize the mismatch inside. There's J.R. Reid getting position on Quinn Snyder. That's really all Snyder can do. Duke's got to do a better job getting back on defense and getting ready to play.
All Snyder can do inside is say, oh no. 18:32 to go in the game. North Carolina by two. We'll be back after this message from Natural Light. This game approved and selected by Raycom Sports, Jefferson Pilot Teleproductions. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, duplication, or reception without the express written permission of Raycom Sports, Jefferson Pilot Teleproductions is prohibited. North Carolina basketball up by two, 39-37.
Duke, who has played pretty good defense all day, Mike, really needs to dig in and maybe get a steal or something so they can create an easy basket in transition.
Right now, Bricky is on J.R. Reid. And at 18-18 to go in the game, J.R. gets his first field goal.
And it's no coincidence, Mike, that the first 4 points of the second half are scored two by Williams, two by Reid.
Strickland double-teamed to King.
Well, that's good defense.
Quinn Snyder for three.
And that's the first Duke field goal since there were 4 minutes and 10 seconds left to go in the first half.
King right now is on Buck Wall. He's the defensive stopper. Now Snyder's on him as they continually switch. And Strickland with a silly foul just runs by and reaches in, slaps him, J.R.
Again, the game inside is very physical, and the play around J.R. Reid always seems to be very physical.
That is the fourth team foul against Duke in the second half. North Carolina has yet to commit one.
And I think that's reflective of the fact that North Carolina is punching the ball inside every time. Ooh, J.R. just
doesn't get the bucket, but will draw the foul.
J.R. created himself some room, moved Bricky off. Watch if we can see it here. J.R. squares up inside. You can see that elbow, and then the hip bounces Robert Bricky first up and then down. Billy King is going to pick up his fourth personal foul, and North Carolina to start the second half has just been relentless in getting the ball inside. Mike Krzyzewski's going to substitute a whole new team. I think he's very displeased with the effort defensively on the inside.
Jay Buckley comes in for the first time, 6'10", freshman, he's number 45. Henderson is into the game. Kubek, 22, is in for the first time. Abdel Nabi, number 30, is into the ballgame. Now, this is the kind of thing that is an object lesson. You guys are going to sit down on the bench. I'm not even going to look at you. But you wonder how long you can afford to leave your second five guys out there.
It all depends on how they perform, Mike. The second five guys might go in there, and with some defensive effort, they might be able to get the game back in line as Reid hits that one. Remember, at the end of the first half, North Carolina completed their run with basically second unit people in the ball game, so it can work.
JR misses the second, and Kubek with the rebound. Also in there, John Cook, number 13, he has the ball. Freshman from Lincoln, Illinois.
Now this is going to be a key point for Duke, particularly on the offensive end of the court.
Abdel Nabi not shy about putting it up, missed the shot, takes a whack at it and commits the foul.
Mike Krzyzewski is, what he's doing is he's pointing up at the scoreboard,
yeah,
and he's telling the officials that look at that, North Carolina has no fouls in the second half, we have six.
Lebo against Cook, who's a pretty good defensive player. Reid covered by Abdel Nabi. Buckley is having to go after Williams.
And Carolina looking inside every time. This is the patience that was missing in the first. And once you start scoring inside and being patient like that, running people off screens, you're going to get open shots not only inside, but a 15-footer like that one by Matt.
Makes it a four-point lead. Abdel Nabi against J.R. Jump hook. Williams got a piece of it. And Lebo with a rebound. Ahead to J.R. Cook is the only one back. What Cook felt like. Here comes J.R., 260 pounds under a full head of steam. The lead is six. Cook almost lost this one. Gets it to Kubek for three. Buckley with a rebound inside, and Williams fouled. That will be three on Scott Williams.
And that is a great job by Buckley. As that three-pointer left the hands of Kubek, it looked clearly off, But Buckley battling inside for position, you know, that's one of those things. If Scott Williams gets this rebound, here you can see Kubek with the long outside shot. Scott Williams gets that rebound and starts the break. You don't know what's going to happen, but Buckley battles very well inside for position.
Chilcutt is in for Williams. Madden also comes out, and Rice is back in for North Carolina. And Mike Krzyzewski has his second five on the court. His starters are sitting on the bench, displeased with what they did. That was the first team foul, by the way, on North Carolina in the second half.
And we have seen a 15-point turnaround, Mike. Duke was up by 9. North Carolina had that 10-1 run to even the game, and now they're ahead by 6.
Cook leans into one a little strong, and Reid clears it. Here comes Rice, picked up by Henderson. Chilcutt, bad pass along the baseline. Madden tried, oh, Bucknell tried to save it and couldn't. And Danny Ferry will now come back in along with John Smith. Snyder also reporting. And a 6-point lead. That move did not hurt him on the scoreboard very badly.
You can play tough defense, Mike, and you can continue to play hard, but it's awfully discouraging on the defensive end if you can't score on the offensive end.
Snyder for 3, buried it.
And that's a big bucket for him.
Snyder's hit 2 of those in the second half. He has 9, and it cuts the lead to 3. Bucknell against Kubek. Lebo posted up Snyder. Missed the shot, and Kubek with the rebound. Ahead to Smith. Basket counts, and he's fouled.
And when you play good defense, Mike, it translates over onto the offensive end. Nice play defensively creates the fast break opportunity. Smith, how he got that ball up there, I don't know. That was an excellent catch. Then watch him as he tries to control the ball here. The dribble gets him back onto the court. He looked like he was going out of bounds. He had to catch that ball. He had to stop. He had to reverse direction. And then he had to put it up through 3 guys.
Tremendous concentration and a chance for a 3-point play, and it can tie the game. We're deadlocked at 46, and all at once it looked like the momentum was all Carolina's with a 6-point lead, but a 3-point shot, then a 3-point play. We're tied again.
Now, one of the things that has happened, one of the people who was substituted into that game when Duke put all 5 guys in was Greg Kubek.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Kubek hasn't scored, but he's bounced Pete Chilcutt on the floor a couple of times. It was he who got that last rebound. We squared off against J.R. Reid, and I think that was what Mike Krzyzewski was looking for, somebody to come in the ball game with that kind of intensity. So even though he hasn't scored a point, I think Kubek is one of the people who's keyed this spurt by Duke.
Krzyzewski loves defense. He'll play hard. J.R. jump hook won't go. J.R. with 5 points, all in the second half. Kubek open for 3. Short. Got it back. And now Duke will reload.
Kubek has certainly not been shy about sticking that 3-pointer since he's come in the game.
Ferry with a turnaround jump shot. And he turns the wrong way that you think he would to be comfortable. But he likes that shot. Bucknell, Kubek on it. Lebo for 3. He's been tough today. Jeff Lebo with 16 points.
And Quinn Snyder just let out a big sigh, put his hands on his hips, sort of to say, what more can you do?
Lebo picks Henderson's pocket. He's got a 2-on-1. Bucknell. Great play by Lebo.
Not only was it a very effective steal, Mike, but he really had to battle Henderson to get the ball up the court. But he was able to see well enough to get it to Bucknell.
Snyder double team. Airmails one. Henderson with a good stab. Lob underneath. Smith wasn't looking. And Williams takes it down. And Dick Paparo warns him that he can't swing the elbows that way. JR. Oh, missed the shot. Are you kidding?
A shot under a lot of pressure, Mike. You expect JR to make that one, but Duke guys were jumping at him. It was not an easy play.
Bucknell knocks it out of bounds. It can't get much more intense.
Henderson never knows what hit him right here. Lebo just reaches from behind. Now watch Lebo control the ball. As soon as he's got it under control, he gets it to his teammate. And you can see right as that picture ends, there's four North Carolina Tar Heels who have beaten everybody from Duke down the court.
Lebo and JR will get a rest. Rice and Madden are the North Carolina guards, and now Smith is in there for a three-guard offense. Fox and Williams are the big guys. Ferry for three. Fox clear to Rice. Three-point Carolina lead. Williams. Ferry got a piece of it and also a piece of Rick Fox's body. That's two on Danny Ferry.
As you continue to go inside, it puts pressure on the defensive guys inside. Williams, no thought about passing this one back out, just goes hard to the basket, draws the foul against Ferry. A good aggressive play by Scott Williams.
Dick Paparo has made a point to talk to both coaches on a couple of trips up and down the court.
And I, you know, as we said in the first half, Mike, I don't think they're social calls.
No. Williams?
In a game that has been this physical, I think the officials have to work extra hard to try to keep it under control, to try to avoid any fighting or any incidents like that. And the officials have done a very good job.
Yep. Williams has made all six of his free throws and has 6 points in the game, but held without a field goal. 12:59 left in the championship game. North Carolina by five. Very nice pass to John Smith.
That was a heck of a catch by Smith. Yeah. I think he thought Ferry was going to shoot the ball and was a little surprised when it ended up in between the two threes on his jersey.
53-50, North Carolina. Ranzino with a baseline drive, missed the runner.
The defense came to help, and Ranzino just flipped it up there.
Strickland with a no look.
Ricky went flying through there.
Lebo and Reid check in as the duo. Fox will come out along with Ranzino Smith. And now Williams also comes out, and Bucknell is in there. Smith.
Smith expected more pressure from JR than he got. He really looked like a shot put in there, real high arc.
Snyder reaches out and kicks it. They'll recycle the shot clock to 45. Billy King will come back into the ball game for Duke. He's working four personals. John Smith is out.
And Billy King is in the ball game, I'm sure, to start after Jeff Lebo.
Lebo, Carolina's leading scorer with 16, only Madden with 11, the only other player in double figures. And that's what's happened with the front court. Carolina certainly more productive in the second half from the big guys. Madden barely avoided the walk. They get it to Reid. It was a nice pass by Rice.
North Carolina doing a good job this half, moving the help away from J.R. Reid.
JR has seven in the second half. The lead is back to five.
Duke has had a tough time getting the ball to its inside people in this half.
Nice pass that time to Ferry for the turnaround. JR had a hand on it, but knocked it out of bounds. Lebo is in perfect position to get it. We've got a timeout. 11:25 to go in the ACC championship game. It's gone back and forth, and right now it's Carolina by five. Near the end of our ball game, we'll be choosing a player from each team as the Holly Farms player of the game. North Carolina leading Duke 55-50 with 11:25 to go, and the winner of this tournament six times in the last 11 years has gone to the NCAA championship game. It's almost like a written invitation, isn't it?
It sure is. This, of course, premier conference in the country.
Year in and year out, it produces just unbelievable basketball. Duke possession, 11:25 to go. The Blue Devils down by five. And this half, both teams cooling off a little bit from their first goal. Really, this Ferry is fouled on the way up. They'd like to get the goaltending on top of it, but I don't think so.
That was a very nicely designed inbounds play. Snyder penetrating Ferry in the middle. Now, it looked like he wanted to pass it to Bricky, but he spun to the basket. The shot is blocked by J.R. Reid. That's foul number four on Scott Williams. And so now both Williams and Billy King have four personal fouls.
And Williams will have to sit down right now.
And that has to hurt North Carolina's attack a little bit, Mike. While Williams only scored 2 points in the first half, the Tar Heels have really been concentrating on going inside in the second.
Very, a very patient free throw shooter.
Makes a lot of them, too.
Yes, he does. 84.3%. Came into the tournament as the number two free throw shooter in the conference. Missed that one, however. Well, 84% means you miss 16 out of 100, I guess. 55-51, Carolina by four. Rice and Lebo the guard. Rice got to the baseline, nowhere to go. Shot it, Madden, or Bucknell, the offensive rebound. He had it blocked.
Bricky in there with the blocked shot. A guy 6'5 can block a shot like that and then do that. You talk about doing it on both ends of the court. He blocked the shot, ran down to the other end, beat most of the people down for that lay-in.
And Quinn Snyder hit him with a beauty. That's the way Bricky played most of yesterday. He was outstanding.
He's only got 5 points today now, and Duke would certainly like to see him be more productive as we get into the latter stages of this, the second half.
Notice Snyder is not going for any of Rice's fakes. He's going to have to prove to him he can shoot it.
JR just really belted Danny Ferry.
Reid, Snyder reached in, got him on the arm.
Just a little early. JR was going to dribble the basketball for him, and if Snyder just waits a second, when JR has it on the floor, he can probably get it. Now, Snyder was four personal fouls, and the foul totals are starting to add up for Duke. There's Bricky with the block shot. Now you see he's the very last guy on the court, but watch him as he runs down the court, gets himself in position. That's a great pass by Snyder. Good catch and lay in by Bricky.
Bricky has great hands. He made that catch yesterday on a play and tremendous body control. Henderson is into the game as Snyder has to sit down with four. Reid on the 1-1. And he missed.
And there's Bricky again.
Duke with a chance to tie or take the lead. They're down by a bucket as we approach the midpoint of the second half.
Haven't heard much from Strickland this half, Mike.
Bricky came up a little short on that one, but kept it alive, and Henderson got it. But he traveled.
One of the problems that you have if you're Robert Bricky is it's difficult to make that power move up through a guy like J.R. Reid when you're only 6'5", and that's what his problem was. He's trying to muscle it up through J.R., just shot it a little short.
Ooh. A couple of times we've had oohs from you today. Reid got away from Ferry and then couldn't hold the ball and just slipped out of his hands. How frustrating for JR.
He's got to reach a little more for that ball, Mike, than he might normally do because of good defense by Danny Ferry.
There you saw the SEC championship update, Georgia, Kentucky.
Big upset for Georgia to win that tournament.
Henderson to King.
Go foul.
Dumps it to Bricky. Kubek for three. Has had no luck from long range yet. Bucknell and Rice on the break. Lebo for three. Put it. Oh, he missed it. I thought that was down. He hadn't missed one all day.
It certainly looked good.
Didn't it ever? King to Bricky. Jump. No, foul on Reid. Thought for a second they might give him the jump ball.
Bricky just doing a great job inside, and you could hear the Duke bench yell, Bricky, Bricky, to make sure that his teammates saw him. That time he takes it up through JR, draws the foul, but just a great job by Robert Bricky to operate inside.
Bricky, a 68% free throw shooter, has hit three out of four from the line today. Ranzino Smith is in for North Carolina. And John Smith is for Duke.
It's amazing how similarly these two teams have attacked one another.
Yeah.
Like North Carolina came out at the start of the second half, punched it inside. The last few times, Duke has been punching it inside. Scott Williams already has four fouls. JR now has three fouls, so the fouls starting to add up for the North Carolina Tar Heels as well. Lebo positioning Ranzino Smith on the lane. Needs some extra help to block out Robert Bricky.
Bricky with a chance to tie. And does with 9:02 left. Now John Smith, who's not allowed to come in before this buzzer, coming in for the shooter, Bricky.
I think we'll see Bricky back in the game very quickly, but Mike Krzyzewski has the luxury of a lot of people on the bench who can play. Smith has 9 points in the game for Duke, so they certainly don't lose anything bringing John Smith in today.
Bucknell gets it to Lebo, and he whistles one across the baseline. Nobody home.
Greg Kubek blasted into John Smith and knocked him down, and that's why Rick Fox was open over in the corner, but Smith was able to get back up and force the bad pass.
8:38 and counting for the ACC championship. We're still tied. Smith doesn't get the shot, but will draw the foul.
And you saw J.R. Reid back away from John Smith. J.R. was underneath the basket there, and as Smith drove to the basket, watch this pass across the court. Now, there's J.R. under the basket. Normally, he'd come to give help, but you watch him back away, conscious of those three fouls. Rick Fox draws the foul.
Three on Rick Fox.
And Duke still continues to go inside. It was Bricky when he was in there, now Smith in there, and Duke starting to get some good production from their post people. We thought maybe Ala Abdelnaby would play a little more today than he did yesterday, or would play based on his performance yesterday.
Right.
Would play a bit more today, but Smith and Bricky have done fine work.
Smith, 3 out of 3 from the line so far. Boy, make them down to 3-3.
A big game, doesn't it, usually?
Yeah.
And the free throws that everybody thinks it comes down to are the ones right at the end of the game.
Smith gives Duke the lead at 56-55. Last time they led was at 48-46.
John Smith matched up against Ranzino Smith.
Lebo with King on it. Chilcutt left wide open and missed. Got a hand on it. Fox tried to save it. Does put to Billy King. Good hustle by Rick Fox. The Duke players standing up. Kubek will pump it out of the corner again. And has just had no luck shooting the ball. Lebo got lucky to save that one. Almost lost it again. Ranzino for three. He's short. JR. Lebo for three. He's missed two in a row. Henderson commits the foul going after Fox. And then Fox is told by one of the officials, you can't slam the ball on the court like that as it went up about 20 feet.
North Carolina standing behind the three-point line and firing away. JR with a big offensive rebound sees his teammate Lebo wide open. The foul is going to be on Phil Henderson. North Carolina doing a very good job on the offensive boards. That's a good decision by Reid to get it out to the wide open Lebo. He's missed a couple in a row now. And Rick Fox throwing the ball down. Now, if that foul had been called on Rick Fox, I do believe that in that situation there would have been a technical called against Fox.
King, Snyder with four, Henderson with three, Williams has four, and Reid with three, and another missed free throw. One thing about free throws and shooting in general, in a game this intense, you get tired, and when you're tired, you miss.
Takes a lot of concentration on the free throw line in a ball game like this.
Bad pass, King can't save it.
Mike, fatigue shows up in other places too, and I think that's a fatigue play right there. Just threw the ball and nobody was home.
Only 7 minutes and 24 seconds to go in the ball game. It's Duke by one over North Carolina. We'll be back after this from Natural Light. Information on our 35 Years of Excellence series, call 1-800-531-5314.
We talking about free throw shooting, Mike, and you can see here that both teams have shot the ball very well today from the free throw line, but as you pointed out, maybe the fatigue factor entering in a little bit here. Those are very good percentages, but we've had a couple of misses by both teams the last few free throw attempts.
That's right. It's a one-point lead for Duke over North Carolina, 7:20 to go in the game. It's been a beauty. Lebo guarded by Snyder. Ferry continues to try to cover Reid.
Well, at this point in the game, Ferry, who's not been covering Reid most of the time, now is on Reid, makes that steal.
Knocked out of bounds by Carolina, preventing the fast break.
But the philosophy there is you don't want Danny Ferry, your offensive gun, matched up against J.R. Reid for 40 minutes, but now there's 7 minutes left in the game, and so Ferry's also a good defensive player, so now you match him up against J.R. Reid.
Under 7 minutes now. Yes, he does. Guy on the other bench isn't bad either. And Bricky asked for a timeout. He was in danger of having a 5-second call against him. So we have a timeout in Greensboro with only 6:44 to go. Duke was still a one-point lead. We'll be back in just a timeouts left. North Carolina has four with 6:44 to go in the ballgame. Blue Devil ball. They're up by one. Williams knocks away the pass intended for Bricky.
And that was a dangerous play by Scott Williams. A good job by Duke to go after him. A lot of times we get a foul coming over the back like that.
And Williams already has four. J.R. Reid with a walk.
J.R. Reid with that little move that he makes down in the post many times has a little hop right before he makes the move. Rarely gets caught, but that time he did.
Quinn Snyder brings it up. Syracuse early over Villanova in the Big East title game. Ferry just inside the three-point line. Hit by Smith. Boy, did he get up, but he couldn't make it go for him. Lebo back the other way. Got caught in the air, and Ferry comes out with a ball.
Good hands by Robert Bricky to break up that pass.
Gotten a little sloppy in the last couple of minutes. That may be fatigue, too.
Well, remember, this is the third game in 3 days for these teams. Duke, in particular, involved in some very intense basketball games.
Ferry to Smith. 5:43 left in the game. Some dangerous passes by both club players. Bricky wants some help. Shot clock is down to 15. Ferry knocked away by J.R. Oh, what a play. Bucknall, Snyder the other one back. Bucknall forced to shoot it and made it.
Now, Bucknall made that shot, but if you're Quinn Snyder going back on the two-on-one break, the best you can hope for is to force that guy to shoot the jumper rather than give somebody a layup. So good defense by Quinn Snyder.
He sure did everything he could, but now Carolina is up by one. John Smith with the jump hook. That basket for North Carolina broke a drought of more than 6 minutes. Baseline jumper won't go by Madden, but Bucknall clears it out. Under five. J.R. Reid has been held 7 points in this ballgame. Williams on the bench has been held for six.
Good ball movement.
Now Williams back in the game, and he gets to touch it. Lebo for three. He's missed two in a row. Now he's missed three in a row, and Ferry with a rebound. Each shot becomes bigger and bigger.
Mike, this game was tied at 37 at halftime. We really have not had much offense in the second half. Both teams going for long stretches without scoring, and these look like two fighters in the 15th round.
That's
here.
Right. 14 against 14, Snyder and Lebo. Ferry for three. Big shot.
That was a right uppercut.
Not the knockout punch yet, but it may be setting it up. 4 minutes and counting. It's a four-point lead for Duke.
Somebody's got to come and get the ball from JR out there. Bucknell was alone.
Oh, wide open. Madden for three. Ricky skies a rebound.
North Carolina started this half punching it inside, inside, inside. Duke has taken that away. And North Carolina now struggling from the three-point area.
And Duke wants to spread it out a little bit. Still a lot of time left, 3:33. John Smith, baseline drive. Oh, that close. run it down by four. Here comes Lebo. To you know who. Missed the shot. Snyder with the ball.
The play continues to be very physical inside. Strickland hadn't scored in this half.
And they want to run some time off the clock with 3:04 left.
And this is really a tough matchup for JR with Reid on the perimeter. It was Ferry on the perimeter, excuse me.
But Danny can handle the ball. They don't have to dribble it until somebody comes out. Shot clock is at 13. Time to run the offense. Ferry. Air ball. Knocked out of bounds out to North Carolina. Well, they did everything they wanted, and who would suspect Danny Ferry would come up with a wide-open jumper and miss everything?
That's one of the hardest things to do, Mike, I think, is to play with the clock. There's not a lot of college basketball teams that do it very well. Duke got what they wanted but weren't able to convert.
2:40 to go in the title game. Duke by four over Carolina.
11 shots.
And that does mean something.
Yes, it does.
And the Blue Devils get down on defense, and everybody slaps the floor. You might remember, I guess it was Amaker who did that so much. To make sure you stay down on defense.
It's going to be done defensively for Duke because you know North Carolina is going to try to punch that ball inside if for no other purpose than to draw the defense inside.
King Rice is in there so Lebo can go back to the shooting guard spot. Williams blocked from behind by John Smith. That'll be three on John Smith, and it was a nice pass by JR.
Again, North Carolina does a nice job creating some room in there for Scott Williams. As the ball goes in, now the help comes, and it comes quickly, but Williams is able to catch it in there and draw the foul, so North Carolina electing, as we suspected, to go inside.
Boy, and Bricky was about 4 feet off the ground in front of Williams in an attempt to block.
He has really shown some impressive physical skills. Now, Billy King is going to come out. Mike Krzyzewski, since his team's about to go over to offense, electing to get a better offensive player.
Williams, on the season, only a 64% free throw shooter, but he has made all seven today and has 7 points. And cut the lead to two. And up. 2:26 left. Here comes the defensive pressure.
North Carolina on a 10-1 run at the end of the first half did it primarily defensively. And they're going to try to do that at the end of the game.
Ferry leans into one. That's one of his favorite shots, but he can't get it this time. And Williams with the rebound.
JR did a nice job not to foul him. Ferry got him off his feet, but JR was able to get away.
King Rice way outside for a three-pointer. Missed it badly, but JR got it back.
And Dean Smith got up and pointed at King Rice and said, Lebo. And that's the guy who wants shooting that three-pointer, not King Rice.
Offensive foul on Bucknall. He pushed off underneath. That'll be three on Bucknall, and Dean didn't like that one.
Now, Quinn Snyder matched up against Bucknall in there. Bucknall knows he has the advantage. That's real good defense by Snyder.
Back about King Rice, he has only made 1 out of 10 three-pointers this year, and it's hard to understand why he's putting up that three-pointer with 2 minutes to go in the ACC championship game. And I think, as you pointed out, Dean had the same wonderment that we did.
Dean probably a little more perplexed than we are.
61-59, Duke by two. The clock becoming so much more important.
King's got to come get the ball.
Lebo reached in, committed the personal foul on Billy King, and if you want to foul somebody, not a bad choice. He's a 47% shooter.
In that situation, if Strickland is going to pick up his dribble, somebody from Duke has to come and take the ball out of his hands. Billy King, while he got fouled, risked somebody coming for a steal. He was trying to stand there, pin Jeff Lebo on his back.
I think Billy may have been hoping somebody else would go help. He didn't want it. Rantino Smith is back in, and King Rice is out of there.
Well, what Dean Smith is doing is getting some offensive players in the game now. King Rice very quick defensively.
Williams is out, so it's Madden, Ranzino Smith, Bucknall, Lebo, and Reid. Strickland, King, Ferry. Looks like Bricky was out there along with Strickland. King missed the free throw. Bricky got a hand on it. Ferry put it in.
Boy, that's exactly what North Carolina wanted, but it was such a funny miss that Robert Bricky was able to control it, tip it to Ferry.
It is a four-point game with 1:15 to go.
Ferry and Reid working real hard against one another inside.
Lebo trying to do anything to create some points. Madden missed the shot. Blocked by Ferry. Foul on Ferry.
Ferry was in trouble from the word go there,
yeah.
Trying to come out and help against Madden. You can see Madden with excellent position. Gets Bricky out of the way. Ferry tries not to foul, doesn't. Then you can see him leave go of the rebound so he doesn't get the foul. But finally, the third time he does get the foul, Bricky falls down. And so Ferry has to come and help. And the guy who comes to help is always in a position where he might foul, and Ferry did.
Madden will go to the line. He's 2-for-2 at the line today. It is a four-point lead for North Carolina. Dean Smith trying to win his 10th ACC tournament championship.
And regardless of what Madden does here, if North Carolina is not able to get a turnover, I do believe that we will see Billy King on the foul line at least a couple more times before the end of this game.
This free throw could cut it to 2. There's a 12-second difference between the game clock and the shot clock, so Duke could not hold it. Williams will come back in. Madden will go out. And full court pressure against the Blue Devils. Ferry wants to take Reid by himself. Comes Rice to help on the trap, but they get it.
You could see JR yelling, come on, come on. He wanted somebody to come to that trap. Now, Billy King is inside against Jeff Lebo. You see, Ferry doesn't want to throw the ball to Billy King. Ricky's only, he's under 60% as a free throw shooter, so he'd be another good guy.
Dangerous pass there by Snyder. Reach in, knocked away, but somehow they got it back. Ferry inside. Shot clock is at 9. Stripped on the way. Here's a 2-on-1 break. Rice and Lebo. And Rice will take it all the way and miss the shot. Rebound to Strickland. Ahead to Bricky. He missed, but it's Duke's ball. And the foul on Lebo with 4 seconds to go. Do you believe that?
What a flurry of activity, Mike.
Oh, man. King Rice had a 2-on-1 break, maybe made the bad decision to take it himself.
I think we're going to see real good defense on this 2-on-1 break. Well, first of all, good defense there. Lebo gets the ball. Now watch how Quinn Snyder plays this. He never really makes a commitment, and by the time he does make a commitment, it's too late for King Rice. Now Bricky's going to miss this. Good defense there by Bucknall.
Yeah.
Quinn Snyder taking it out. This is all North Carolina can do. Lebo feels like he's got pretty good position there.
But sure Lebo, looked like it, didn't it?
Lebo gets called for the foul. See the reaction from the North Carolina bench. Dean Smith wants the foul right there. He is not very happy about that.
And now you see him not be happy. You almost got a chance to see him not be happy the second time in about 3 seconds.
Well, what he was doing, he was slapping his hands together, telling his players to hurry up and foul. But Jeff Lebo, you talk about a guy who's always thinking, he's not going to concede the foul. He tried to step in there and draw a charge.
Take a charge. Well, here's the situation. 4 seconds left. Duke is on top 63-61. Take a look at our Holly Farms players of the game for Duke. Danny Ferry, 19 points, 10 rebounds, 4 assists, and Jeff Lebo with one of his finest offensive games late in the season, 16 points, 6 rebounds, 3 assists, and you saw the hustle of Jeff Lebo late in this ball game. Holly Farms will contribute $1,000 to the Atlantic Coast Conference to be distributed among the member institutions under a conference-approved plan. Our congratulations to Danny Ferry and Jeff Lebo. So Snyder will go to the free throw line. He can ice this one.
He's an 80% free throw shooter on the year, Mike. It's the first time that he's been at the free throw line today.
And a lot of options open. You're down by two. If he misses the first shot, what do you do? If he makes the first, it's a three-point lead. Obviously, you got to go for three. If he makes them both, back up the bus.
All those options, as you just mentioned, are squarely in the hands of Mr. Quinn Snyder. There aren't any options if he makes two.
And he wanted the ball, clapping his hands, and took it from Joe Forte. Got the first one.
I mean, it's an exhilarating feeling to have the ball game right in your hands.
And it is right now.
4-point lead.
Now, the only thing Duke has to do is not foul.
And they've intercepted it. Bricky's got the ball. That's it. The Blue Devils have won it.
Lebo, who worked so hard all year long, play so hard, and come up short in the ACC championship. The final 65-61, Duke over North Carolina. Let's go to Paul Cameron. He has Quinn Snyder. Well, we'll get Paul and Quinn Snyder there in a second. As you can see, it's sort of a madhouse out here on the court, and we're getting a cameraman down there right now. The second half of today's game was sponsored in part by Holly Farms, by Winn-Dixie, and by Mazda.
Mike, just a superior effort by two real fine basketball teams.
It was a great game and all we could ask for. Let's go to Paul Cameron.
Boy, jubilation. Quinn Snyder just did a triple gainer. Yes. Two in 3 years on this floor. Quinn, ice water on your veins. You hit the icers there on the free throw line.
Well, it happened so fast. Robert came up with a great play. Kevin got that rebound on the end, and I was fortunate just to follow it, and he missed the layup, and I was found myself with the ball, and next thing I knew, I was on the line.
Unbelievable. Coach, take the mic and ask Danny something.
Well, Danny, how's it feel? That's your second one.
Feels great. It really does. It's really a special feeling. We had a tough time about 2 weeks ago, and we really got things together. We really did this together. That's what makes it even more special.
Well, I know you've been wanting to get into ACC and play ever since you was a little guy, because I know you put in a lot of hard work and sweat. It's worth it, isn't it?
Definitely, definitely. This is a great feeling. I think this conference is underrated because there's so many good teams, and you know, a lot of people talk about the Big Ten and so on. They're very good, but you know, we got to get our respect somewhat, too.
Hey, you think your dad, Bob, will take you out for a steak tonight?
Probably not. He'll probably head back.
Hey, I guarantee you he'll find something you did wrong today, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. But he'll say a lot good.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you, Coach.
I got one more question for you, Danny. You were definitely my MVP of this tournament and maybe player of the year in the conference. Do you agree with that?
Well, I don't know. I'm just really happy. We did it together as a team, and that's what makes it so fun, is we did it all together. Special feeling.
Great jubilation for these Duke Blue Devils. Let's go down to Bob Rathbun right now.
Okay, thank you, Paul. With me is the head coach, Mike Krzyzewski. Our congratulations, Mike. Fantastic.
Anyone who says it doesn't mean anything, they're crazy. This is a very, very special moment for our basketball team, this ACC tournament championship. We're just we're just so fulfilled right now. And you can take a look at our kids, how much it meant to them to win this thing.
Well, you had to wonder, Mike, coming down the stretch, they had anything left. They really gutted it up.
Well, both teams did. I thought Carolina played an outstanding. They came right out and attacked us. And at the start of the half, I thought they had the momentum. We seemed to be really tired. And that group came off the bench and did a good job. Kubek, although he missed some shots, was a spark for us. John Smith. And then when the veterans got back in, they seemed to have a renewed life. And it just worked out well for us.
Hard to believe to beat the Tar Heels three times.
Well, the numbers are not relevant. The championship is what's relevant. And, you know, for these kids, some of these kids to do it two times in 3 years. I told them that before the game. It's just it's the opportunity of a lifetime. Don't worry about NCAA seeds or three in a row or anything like that. Play for a championship today. Have fun and go after it. And that's what they did.
The championship is theirs. Now it's on to the NCAAs.
But we're going to enjoy this for about a day.
There you go.
Thank
Congratulations.
You. Thank you.
Mike Krzyzewski, the head coach of the Blue Devils. Now let's go to the ball camera.
You know, a lot of people have worked many, many long hours to bring you the best possible coverage, television-wise, of ACC basketball. Yet without superb players and coaches, of course, it wouldn't all be possible. We want to thank them. Duke has won the tournament. For the next few days, they're going to be in the limelight. And for the players and coaches that did not win, well, they'll be back in the high life here on the ACC.
Bob Rathbun, Mike Patrick, Dan Bonner, Lefty Dizel, and all of our entire crew here in Greensboro. This is Paul Cameron, thanking you for joining us today. You've been watching exclusive coverage of Atlantic Coast Conference basketball on Raycom Sports and Jefferson Pilot Teleproductions. From Greensboro, Duke beats North Carolina for the 1988
ACC. Ethnic groups, you see this afternoon, the conference has a new champion. Rick Sullivan joins us now with an update. Rick?
Boy, it is not too often, if ever. I can't remember when Carolina has ever been beaten three times in one season, but by the same team. Duke did it today, 60.